smart. This is pretty simple. to cut the deficit, you either have to cut spending or raise taxes. And it doesn't look like spending is going down.
Right. And I'm not going to go to the argument that, you know, you cut marginal rates, because that's only proven three times over history that's how you raise revenue. But look at California. Let's use California as a perfect example. 1% of people in California pay 50% of the income tax. Now, they have already seen that their collections are going to be down somewhere in the 18%. They're already down 12% in the fourth quarter, but they're going to be down 18%. Why? Number one, people are moving. Number two, they're rearranging their affairs, so they're not going to be stuck in this thing. And number three, is it really fair that 1% of people pay for the other 50% for all their services? No, it is not fair.
Okay, Eric, what's the math
here? Let me jump on
Toby's bandwagon here. Mayor Bloomberg came out, New York City mayor, this week, and he said he confirmed it. 1% of the residents in New York City account for 50% of the tax revenue. That's the number. He's made this very clear. If you lose any of those people, a handful of those people, our tax receipts will go down. Listen, do you know how you incentivize people to stay and come here? You lower the taxes. You don't raise the taxes.
Is it really fair?